नाउ लेट्स कम टू नेक्स्ट कैटेगरी ऑफ किंगडम प्लांटेड, दैट इज टेरिडोफाइट्स. सो वी नो दैट टेरिडोफाइट्स आर द फर्स्ट ऑर्गेनिजम्स दैट हैव वेल डिफरेंशिएटेड रूट, स्टेम एंड लीफ. एग्जाम्पल्स आर हॉर्स टेल्स एंड फर्न्स. सो दीज आर द फर्स्ट टेरेस्ट्रियल प्लांट्स विच हैव जाइलम एंड फ्लोएम. सो वी नो वॉट इज जाइलम एंड फ्लोएम. दे आर द टिश्यूज प्रेजेंट इन द प्लांट. जाइलम इज यूज फॉर वाटर कंडक्शन एंड फ्लोएम इज यूज फॉर फूड कंडक्शन. सो द ब्रायोफाइट्स लिव इन द कूल एंड डैम्प प्लेसेस. लेट्स अंडरस्टैंड द स्ट्रक्चर. द मेन प्लांट बॉडी इज अ स्पोरोफाइट, दैट इज इट इज अ डिप्लॉयड ऑर्गेनिज्म. इट इज अ प्लांट विच बियर्स द स्पोर्स एंड इट इज डिफरेंशिएटेड इन टू रूट, स्टेम एंड लीव्स. सम ऑफ द लीव्स आर स्मॉल and the small leaves are called as microphylls. Example, Selaginella. Selaginella is example of pteridophytes. Or some leaves are also large, like they are called as macrophylls. For example, ferns. Ferns are called as ornamental plants. The sporophytes bear the sporangia. What is the sporangia? It is a sac-like structure that contains millions of spores. And the sporangia is present on the sporophyll. What is a sporophyll? Sporo is a spore and phyll is a leaf. So it is a leaf that bears the spores. Now in some different types of plants, these sporophylls will form compact structure called as strobili or cones. It means that all the sporophylls will combine with each other. They will form a group of sporophylls and the group of sporophylls is called strobili or cone like structure. It resembles a cone, that's why it's called a cone. Examples: Selaginella, Equisetum. Let's understand the life cycle. So we know that sporangia produces spores by meiosis in spore mother cell. What is meiosis? It is a sexual reproduction, also called as reduction division. Now after the spores are produced, they will germinate and give rise to multicellular free living gametophytes. What are gametophytes? They are the plants which bear the male and the female gametes. These gametophytes will further grow in the damp places. Now, because of some restricted requirement and the need for water for fertilization, the spread of these plants is limited to some geographical locations. Let's look at sexual reproduction in these plants. The gametophytes bear the male and the female sex organs. It is called as antheridia and archegonia. Water is required for the transfer of antherozoids to the archegonia. That is, water is a medium of sexual reproduction. Without water, the process of sexual reproduction is incomplete. Fusion of the antherozoids and the archegonia occurs in the presence of water and gives rise to the zygote. What is zygote? It is a new young individual produced after fertilization. Now this zygote will further undergo development. It will produce a multicellular sporophyte that is called as a dominant phase of the pteridophytes. So we know what is a sporophyte. Sporophyte is a plant that bears the spores and sporophyte is the diploid stage of plant. Now in pteridophyte, the sporophytes are of two types. First type is called as homosporous. Homo means same. All the spores are of similar types and this is found in majority of the pteridophytes plants. Second type is heterosporous. Hetero means different. There are two different types of spores. They are called as small and large spores. The small is a male microspore and large is a female megaspore. Example, Selaginella. Selaginella is example of pteridophytes. So Selaginella and the megaspore and the microspore, they will germinate and give rise to the male and the female gametophytes. So the female gametophytes are present on the parent sporophytes for some period of time. So you have a parent sporophyte. Over the parent sporophyte, there is the development of the female gametophyte in these types of plants. So the female gametophyte will grow above the parent sporophyte. Development of the zygote into the embryo will occur inside the female gametophyte. So after the process of fertilization, the zygote is produced. What is zygote? It is a young individual. Now this zygote will further undergo development. That is, it will further grow. It will grow to give rise to an embryo. What is embryo? It is a little greater stage, or you can say it is a further stage of the development of zygote. And the process of formation of the embryo will occur inside the female gametophytes. Now this habit, it is considered as an important step in the evolution because it gives rise to the formation of seed. Let's look at some economic uses of pteridophytes. Now these are plants, so we already know the uses of plants. They are used for medicinal purposes and they are soil binders, that is, they protect from soil erosion. They are also frequently used as ornamental plants for beautification. They are used and they are kept in the houses, in the commercial complexes, in the offices, in the gardens and different locations, because they are called as ornamental plants. Now pteridophytes are further divided into four classes. First is Psilopsida, example is Psiloptum. Second is Lycopsida, example Lycopodium. Lycopodium is also used as a homeopathic medicine to cure some types of diseases. Equisetum is example of Sphenopsida, and Pteropsida is the class, and the examples are Pteris, Adiantum and Dryopteris. Let's take a look at some of the examples. So you can see the Equisetum. It has a scale leaf-like structure. Lycopodium has a sessile leaf-like structure. And Adiantum is also example of a pteridophyte. These are examples where there is a formation of a cone or strobilus in pteridophytes. So strobilus is singular and strobili is plural. First is Equisetum, next we can see Selaginella, third Osmunda, and fourth is Lycopodium. These are some more examples: Selaginella, Pteris, Dryopteris, Adiantum and Equisetum. This is a diagram of a fern plant. It's an ornamental plant, and you can observe there are brown color spots present below the surface of the leaf of the fern plant. Now these brown spots are the sporangia, and you can see in the diagram each sporangia contains so many spores.